Hi, welcome to my kitchen. I'm Lydia, and today I'm so lucky to have Terry with me.
I'm lucky because I love what you cook.
Yay! She's the station manager at OCTV, and she's gonna help me because today we're going to make a recipe. You heard it right, we're gonna make a recipe. So normally when I cook, not all the time, but a lot of the times, I just kind of throw things together. So I kind of put everything on the counter that I would throw into a bowl. So, but what we're going to do differently is we're going to make the recipe so people could make it at home.
Nice.
And Terry came up with a great name, Harvest Muffins. Yeah. You can see some of the ingredients in it. This is whole wheat flour. And we're going to try to use the most, we're going to use the minimum amount of whole wheat flour because I have my almond meal from my almond milk that I made. So that's what this is. And that's what this is over here as well. And what I did was I put it in my little coffee grinder to grind it up. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And at the same time, if you want to take seeds out of this.
Scoop.
Before you do, I'll just.
This is the harvest part, right?
Yes, this is the harvest part, and it's the cutest little, butternut.
Sweet butternut squash.
Yeah, and I bought it at Vogler's, and she said it's supposed to be the sweetest squash, and I did have it without putting it in the muffins first, and it was good, but it tasted very starchy.
Oh.
I liked it, mm-hmm. And you can taste it if you want to. Yeah. But I thought, you know what, I'm going to bake with it instead, like in a muffin.
Well, that's
so that's why that I ended up making muffins.
There's another squash, I think it's called a sweet potato squash. Mm-hmm. That's a really sweet squash, and it's about this size, so that probably would be a good squash.
Oh, yeah, I think I know, with the stripes on it, the green stripes.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
right. There's actually a name for it. What is the name?
I don't remember, except for sweet potato squash.
Yeah,
me to start scooping this out and putting it in a bowl?
Yes.
Okay.
Wait, use this bowl because I was gonna switch that. Because this is gonna be our dry ingredients. And it doesn't matter. There's a little bit in there, but
that's fine.
And that's gonna be our wet ingredients.
So we're gonna scoop the seeds out of this one first, right?
That.
You already did one.
And if you want to taste it, here's a clean spoon. If you want to try it.
I do want to taste it because I love squash.
So I'm gonna go ahead and grind up my almond meal.
So with this, you just baked it for at 350 for a half hour or something.
It was about 40 minutes. Thank you. That needs to go in the recipe.
Big squash muff.
I've had this thing for, just 25, 30 years and $10 at the time, but oh my gosh. And I only use it for nuts. And then I have one for herbs and then of course coffee. So it's a really great little way to get something ground up. You'll see how nice it works.
So I see what you're saying, it's kind of a starchy taste, so mm-hmm. I would definitely either use the butternut or the sweet potato squash. There's so many cool squashes out there now.
Oh my gosh, you really could, and you could even use sweet potatoes to make this. So yeah, there's recipes
or
with
pumpkin,
squash.
Maybe?
And to me what they replace is like a sour cream or a heavy cream that you might add to make a muffin.
Okay.
So that's what I use it for. However, today we're going to use this squash, and now we have all of our almond meal, but we need to measure it. If we're going to make a recipe, we got to be exact.
Okay, almond meal flour. Okay, almond.
There's the oven. I set it for 375. Pardon me?
Isn't that liquid measure?
It is, but I always use it. Thank you, though, for noticing. So, because that's a liquid measure, we're going to be using this lovely half. However, we're going to, I do use liquid measures for my dry, but someone in the background is right. You're supposed to use metals for, anyway. I'm going to still use it, but I'm going to measure it with this. So if that makes sense, no one knows. Okay, so we're going to
start out with.
It actually doesn't make sense. So that's half a cup, but I'm still using this. So now it's one cup. I just want to see how much almond meal we have here. Because again, the point is I want to use as much of this and as little as this as I can.
The less flour we use, the better off we are.
Yes.
Yeah.
And, you know, I wanted to call them healthy muffins, but it's a harvest muffin, but I am thinking on the healthy side, of course.
Yes, of course.
Okay, so that's a cup and a half.
Okay.
And then, so we're just going to call it a cup and 3/4.
Okay.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So we have a cup and 3/4 of almond flour. It's going in here. Again, my oven is preheated to 375. I did try to make this recipe before. So as far as the sweetener, I'm going to use this maple syrup. You all know where it's from. It's organic too.
Love it.
You know where it's from, right? Because I always mention.
Is that from New Hampshire?
Trader Joe's. I always mention Trader Joe's. Yeah. So I don't know how much of that we want to use yet. And this is also dependent on what? This is also dependent on.
Did we have something on fire?
How much of this that you add is dependent on how sweet your squash is. So we're going to wait a minute.
Yep.
So what'd you think when you tasted it?
It needs a sweetener.
Yeah.
It's not as sweet. I know there's other squash out there that's sweeter than this. But yeah, I think the maple syrup would just be just exactly what it needs. Or you could use agave too, right?
Agave, brown sugar. Yep.
Yeah.
Anything you want. We're gonna try it with this. So why don't you go ahead and put I'm gonna put a teaspoon of baking soda in my flour here. Write that down. And then I'm gonna also put in some of our Vietnamese cinnamon. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. I always use more than a recipe might say, so I'm gonna go ahead and put in 2 heaping teaspoons. You can just say that. So that's our dry so far.
Oh, that smells amazing.
Oh, you want to hear smell it again.
It's so fragrant. Wow.
So wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Okay, so I'm gonna let
That's you... funny that there's different scents in cinnamon.
Yeah, some are more potent.
Very fragrant.
Go ahead and put that egg in there, and then I'm going to have you use this mixer to combine everything.
Oh, good. I get to make noise.
You get to make noise. It's always
fun.
And
so this is a room temperature egg?
Yes, I did. I don't always remember to, but today I did. And we're hoping we don't have to use 2 eggs.
Okay.
But we'll see.
Well, we can have half and half that way.
Yeah.
Okay, 1 egg so far.
And this was room temperature too, so that's helpful. Okay, so there's that.
All right, you want me to start on that?
Yeah, and I'm going to add a teaspoon.
Make some noise.
Oh, bring it down a little bit. I know it goes on. There you go.
How do you?
Is it on the low? It's on the lowest, I think.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Yeah, that's working.
Yeah.
And you're going to add vanilla?
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, you can turn it up.
Seems to be going faster.
Yeah, I know. It's a fast mixer. The reason I got it so I don't lose those things is because it attaches to it. So it worked out well.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Teaspoon of...
1 teaspoon.
I'm doing kind of a heaping teaspoon. I always add more vanilla too. So a very heaping teaspoon of vanilla. Got that in. I brought a lemon out thinking we might want to use some, but I don't know. We'll decide. In a little
I'm
bit.
Stir this or spin it again?
Sure,
or
go
just
ahead.
Stir it with
I'm just
a
gonna
spoon.
Whisk this together.
Make some more noise. So the egg that we used was just a medium sized egg?
Good point. Yes, a medium sized egg.
1 medium egg.
I'm gonna go ahead and put a teaspoon of salt in my dried as well.
Okay.
I've always been hesitant to use salt in sweet, but you know what? It really brings out the sweet. It's amazing how much. So yeah, I'm going to use a whole teaspoon of that. So that's in.
Okay.
This is in. This has been in. Okay, so now we're going to decide how much sweet. Well, not now. First, we're going to add some lovely coconut oil. I took out butter at first, and then I thought, you know what?
Let's try coconut oil.
Yes.
That makes it a little bit richer, I think.
Yeah. And you can get this at Meijer, but I got it at Trader Joe's.
Trader Joe, yeah.
So now that's the other thing. We're going to have to measure this. So I think what we'll do is do it in tablespoons.
Yep.
So I think, and when of course I'm guessing.
1 would be good.
But I'm thinking 4.
Oh.
No?
Oh, why not?
Know. Well, let's do 2.
Okay.
Let's do 2. Can you help me scrape it out a little?
Smooch it out of there.
That's not going to work. Here, let me get this.
2 TSBs.
2 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. And maybe that is enough, because I'm thinking of it as a solid, but it definitely is not going to be a solid.
It will, it'll break down.
I feel so awkward measuring something right now, because I'm so used to not measuring.
Oh. So yeah, that's right. A little bit more.
I think I should?
Sure.
Okay, put a heaping.
Let's try.
Heaping. A heaping tablespoon of coconut oil. These are going to be so healthy
good,
for you.
Good. I love coconut oil. I could just eat it by the spoonful.
Pardon me?
Heaping Harvest Muffins.
Yes.
Oh, there you go.
Heaping Harvest Muffins. Yes. Yes. Okay.
Nice.
Very nice. I just had another brainstorm. I was thinking.
Good.
Instead, you know, you might not say good. I was thinking instead of this, we could put in a teaspoon, not a tablespoon, but a teaspoon of apple cider vinegar. What do you think?
Oh, I would.
Should we?
Sure, why not?
Let's do it.
Why not? Something inspired you to do that.
Yeah. What?
Okay.
We don't know. We're going to put a teaspoon, just a teaspoon. Don't put more.
Apple cider.
Yeah, it will just give it a little tiny tang. And then, of course, if these muffins don't taste good, guess what? Where that recipe is going to go?
Right there? In the
circular right there. Aisle? Okay. Do you think we have everything? I think we have everything.
A little bit of sugar.
Oh, no. You're right.
Maple syrup. Yes. I'd do a tablespoon, maybe.
I was about to pour it in. Can't just pour it in, Lydia.
No, you got to start out with that tablespoon.
Tablespoon. I think we'll do 2 tablespoons.
Okay.
And then we'll taste it. Okay. So that's in there. I think I have a feeling we're going to need a little more, but we'll see.
I don't know.
Again, I feel like it's dependent on your squash. So maybe taste your squash before you make the recipe.
Yeah, right.
And then we always use a ton of spoons when we cook.
Okay.
So go ahead.
Good.
You taste it. I'll taste it. Oh, wow. Sweet.
Mm-hmm.
You were
That's
right.
All you need.
I don't think we need anything else.
And I do like the vinegar in there.
Yeah.
It gives that little edge.
All right, now we're going to add this. And then again, with That's our good. Whole wheat flour, we're going to determine if we need it after we add all of the almond flour.
And that was how much? It was 1¾.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm like, please tell me you wrote it down.
I did.
You did. This is cool. This is fun to make a recipe.
It is fun.
I mean, this
I've
is
never
how recipes
done that
are
before.
Born. People always think, oh, I gotta find a recipe. Well, you know what? You can make your own recipe.
Yeah. Don't be intimidated by it, that's for sure.
Yeah. And I think that anybody who makes their own recipe should share it at OCTV.
I agree.
In the comments. We would
yes.
love it.
Facebook.
And also if you try it.
Community Television Facebook. Put it on there. This might look like a cookie.
Yeah. You know what? When I made it before, it was like this.
Okay.
I don't even think we need any whole wheat.
I don't think so either.
We're going to be right back. We're going to finish this up, get it in the oven, and then we're going to make we made a savory schmutz before, which is a sausage roll.
Can't wait.
Today, we're going to make a peach one from the peaches from the tree, and we'll be right back.
Yay.
Hi, and welcome back. We made a few changes to our recipe, which is perfectly fine. That's the beauty of making your own.
Yeah.
So
there's only 2 of them. The apple cider vinegar, we're doing 3/4 of a teaspoon. And then the maple syrup, we're doing 3 teaspoons. And the salt, we're doing 3/4 of a teaspoon.
Right. We felt like
Instead
it was a little
of a
bit
full
salty.
Teaspoon, yeah. So.
But we really like the addition to the apple cider vinegar. You don't really detect like vinegar. It's just gives it a little of a tang, which you could do with lemon. That's why I wasn't sure which one we wanted to do.
I like the apple cider vinegar because it's that harvesty thing.
Yes.
Whereas lemon would be summery.
Very good.
So,
yes.
There you go.
Okay, so now this dough was in my freezer from the last time we made our sausage roll schmutz. Not dirt, though. There's no dirt added. So this, I cannot get over how wonderful this dough freezes. So it's been in the freezer for a week. Yeah, I wouldn't put it in for more than a month, but you definitely can put it in for a week or two. Really.
And then you took it out, like, do you let it thaw overnight, or how do you do that?
Yes, I took it out last night, kept it in the fridge, and this morning I wanted it to be room temperature. Mm-hmm. So I took it out before we started filming.
Okay.
And what is so amazing about it is it's easy to deal with. I don't know if anybody's ever made dough before, but you can make dough, and it can be so difficult. You're tough. Oh my gosh, I can't. But this one is just so soft. Feel how soft. I know
it
you
is.
Just
I
washed
did
your
wash
hands.
My hands.
We all
I
washed
did.
Our hands.
It is soft. Wow.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Maybe you want to do this part.
Mm-hmm.
You want to?
I'm rolling it.
Sure. Just
Yay.
Go ahead. We're, you know, we're easy. So you just start rolling it. And I had a thought, instead of making it into, like, jelly rolling it. And you know what? We can just take a vote. because either way is fine.
You're so easy.
I try to be easy. I don't know if everyone on this earth
Does
would agree with
feel
you.
That way?
Certainly not my children. So what I was thinking is, you know how you've seen those beautiful tarts in, like, window
the
displays?
Flan kind of tarts.
Yeah, so it's
yeah.
like the dough is coming up
yes.
around it, and then the.
Yes.
I don't know. I was thinking it, but maybe
sure.
we don't.
Sure. That's rustic that way.
We have someone in the audience who says, no, you should be making it like a schmutz. Because, Lydia, that's
schmutz-y.
What you said you would do. Okay, so right, so we're going to make
yes,
it like a schmutz.
That could deserve yours.
So what I, wanted to, tell you, okay. stop for a second, is so because we're going to make it into a schmutz, we want it to be this oval type shape.
Okay.
So we want it to be like this shape, but a lot bigger.
Oh, got it.
So just start.
Got it.
I'm gonna, maybe this will be easier, too. Start doing it like that.
Yeah.
Okay, and I just wanted to tell you, too, with our recipe for the Harvest Muffins, we added some chocolate chips. Now, in this combination, I added, these are little caramel chips, chocolate chips, and white chips. And, of course, you could do whatever you wanted. So what I did is I put them on top when everything was in the muffin tin, and then I added a tiny bit of sugar to the top of the muffins. So those are baking. We put the oven on for 15 minutes, and we're seeing if it takes longer, which I have a feeling it will. But right now, 15 minutes, but we'll let you know for the recipe how
yep,
long they
for
take.
Sure, right.
And then this is our beautiful.
How's this looking?
Looking good. We wanted to get it even thinner, and you let me know if you want me to take over. I took peaches out of my freezer from the tree that we had. We harvested them, cut them all up. I put them in my freezer. I have a big chest freezer in my basement, lucky enough to have one. And this morning, I put them in my fridge last night, took them out this morning, and they were all defrosted. I will say something about what I've noticed with the peaches that I'm freezing. If I take them out and put them in the fridge for a couple days, they get really brown. So I wanted to kind of preserve the color. So that's why I waited and just let them defrost overnight, and the color did stay pretty well.
Does it help maybe if you put lemon or some kind of acid in that?
I did.
To keep the color?
I put some zest in.
Okay.
Thank you. I would have forgot to say that. I put some lemon zest in. I put some cinnamon in, which will make it a little bit of a cinnamon color, so that's what you're seeing.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's the peaches, and then I put in about a half a cup of sugar. I did put sugar in this.
And then, did you peel them? Or
no.
So you don't even have to peel them.
You do that. I'm telling you, all recipes you find say peel the peaches. I've never peeled them. So when I freeze them, I don't peel them.
Wow, that's awesome.
And when you taste this and when you make this, you'll see for yourself that you're not going to be going, oh, there's peel in here. You don't worry about it. But also what I wanted to say is if you do want to try to make this, you can simplify this. You can buy canned peaches. I would recommend buying syrup free, just in their own juice.
Right.
You can buy frozen bread dough. You can buy crescent rolls that you, the crack things. I don't even know what they're called, the crack things.
Crack.
And then you got a really quick, fast dessert. So this is the old fashioned way, which of course we all love. But you can make this super quick too.
What did you do to prepare them for freezing?
These, I just cut them up. Took most of the seeds off, washed them, of course, first. I will say we had peach cobbler a couple weeks ago, and somebody found a seed. That was lovely. The good news is it's good friends.
And it didn't break their teeth, right?
No, and it, yeah, really, that would be the worst. Now, when you're doing this, try to make it a tad wider. So go side. Okay. Let's flip it this way.
Okay.
And then you can make it a little bit wider. The reason it's a little bit got these brown streaks in is because I've used whole wheat flour to just dust.
To dust the board. Yeah.
So anyway, wash the peaches, cut them up, and really I bought freezer bags and threw them in my freezer.
How nice.
Didn't add sugar. I just figured
easy. Wow.
It's better to control the sugar when you're
making
cooking. Yeah.
Yeah. Got it.
So
very easy.
Now what we're gonna do is that looks absolutely perfect. Just do a tad there. Perfect. Again. no, I don't think I'm not gonna put it in the pan yet. But I do have a pan with parchment prepared.
Okay.
You just watch the magic of Lydia. Okay, so here's the biggest thing. The middle. I'll do it.
Go for it. I want to see what you're doing.
Yeah. This is where I feel like experience has helped.
It smells so good.
Yeah, that Vietnamese cinnamon.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
I can be honest, though, I've never made a sweet one of these. And I've been doing this for 40 years, and I've never made...
Oh, really?
Yeah, so this is exciting.
Fun.
And
yeah.
my first original plan... Our lovely cameraman had suggested doing apples, which I bought, but this morning I thought, you know what, I'm just going to have time to do one.
Yeah.
So I decided to do just the peach one. But I have apples, now I need to eat those.
You can do those with apples too.
Yeah, so you could use apples, anything you want. So this is the crazy part where people are like, oh my gosh, it's just such a mess. And again, with experience, it won't be a mess. So now you're going to take it and you're going to flip it. So this is called jelly rolling.
Okay.
Where you flip it like this, and then you just pinch it down. Again, you want parchment paper.
Too?
Yep, everywhere you can. And then I kind of do this too. I flatten it down a little bit.
Okay.
Pull this one out a little bit because this one's going over.
Okay.
So nothing's perfect, but, and again, it can be very messy. And I'm not going to worry about my mat or anything. We're just going to pile them on here. I would use a mat. This is going to be very full.
That's really neat.
Since we're using all the peaches.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Wow.
So this is the harder part when you have to flip it over. So you just take it and you just go over like that. Thank you.
Oop.
I know. This is going to be the hard part. And it, trust me, I had the same issues when I did...
The sausage.
Yeah, not so much on camera, but in the past when I first did it.
Just
take
escaping.
It out. No worries. All right, I know you're gonna have to wash your hands, so I'll transfer it to the pan. Gee, maybe we should have put it on the pan first. Just kidding. I'll let you wash your hands.
All right, you transfer.
Yeah, I'll transfer it. Very messy, yes. Bring over your pan. And the magic of gravity. We get it over.
Look at that.
So now I'm feeling like this is really moist. So what I think I'm going to do is I think I'm going to put a couple of toothpicks in to hold it.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. Let me grab this. Rinse off again.
It sure smells good.
Yeah.
Wow.
So again, I've never done it with sweet. Now I see that liquid might be an issue. It might be better to make this a little bit drier. So I don't know. But we're going to use toothpicks. Maybe. Oh, good. There they are.
It's starting to roll.
Is it really? Oh, wow.
This will
work.
Right there. Yep.
Here, let's turn it this way, too, so nobody can see what's happening. No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding. It will be fine. Look it, we're sewing now. This is sewing class now. Just going to add these lovely, because seriously, once it bakes up,
it'll stay put.
And it's going to look pretty.
Yeah.
You could put sugar over this. I don't think I am. I'm just going to get it in the oven as fast as I can.
Are you going to do an egg wash?
I don't think I'm going to do an egg wash because there's so much sugar on it right now.
One more.
Unless you think.
It might get awfully dry back here.
You think I should put
it? I think it wouldn't hurt.
No? Okay. Yep. Of course I do. We're going to just throw that in there. Throw this in here.
Nice.
Grab an egg. Look, I got the smallest egg on earth.
Oh, that's so cute.
My daughter has chickens, so.
Ah.
You never know what you're going to get.
Yeah. I like the double yolkers.
Do you know what's happened, though? Yeah, those are fun. Now that they have chickens, she has two little boys, nobody will eat the eggs.
Because they like the chickens?
Yeah. Aww. They become pets. They follow the boys all over the place.
Aww.
And they're all the chickens. And they just feel like it's part of the chickens. So they're having a hard time eating eggs. Isn't that funny?
Oh, that is funny. Yeah. To me, I love fresh chicken eggs. Oh, my
they're
goodness.
They're the best.
So good. Yep.
Oh, look, it just happens to be right here.
Look at that.
So we're just going to go ahead and do our little...
So you use the whole thing?
I use the whole egg.
Yolk and the whites,
yep.
Not just
the whites.
Do you
sometimes just use whites?
Sometimes I do.
Oh, I didn't. I never thought about it.
But I'm doing.
Yeah, plus it would give it a clear color.
Yes.
This is going to give it more of a golden color. So.
That's all right, too.
Yeah.
Nice.
So here's the biggest thing.
Beautiful.
Don't forget to take out the toothpicks.
It's right. Beautiful, really.
Yeah. So my muffins are in there. My timer's about to go off, and we're
going to
check them.
In here.
So, they've been going for 15, which I don't know if they're done. They are not done. They're still soft to the touch. Never stick your finger in chocolate because it will burn you.
It does hurt. So you don't have to do the toothpick thing in the middle or the knife in the middle.
Yes, you should. Absolutely. You should check them with a toothpick. These are kind of... but I can just by touching and not having spring back. I think it needs like another 5 minutes or so.
Okay, and we said 25, so let's say 30 now. Change your recipe to 30 minutes so far.
Yeah, they've been in 15.
Oh, okay.
So we're gonna make them for another 10 minutes.
All right, so that's what we originally said was 25 minutes.
We're going to take a break, a quick break, and then we will come back and we'll see what our muffins look like, and maybe the schmutz will be done. Hopefully.
They both
okay.
smell good.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
There's a blood shortage, and we came up to Dead Lover's Point at midnight on Friday the 13th.
Lame.
Guess I'm going to waste all this blood by dying in a predictable horror movie way.
50% of Americans like watching blood get spilled in horror movies, but only 3% donate it.
When was the last time you donated blood?
Catch us anytime on YouTube. Go to Oxford Community Television YouTube.
Hi, and welcome back. We're just going to take the muffins out of the oven. They're looking quite beautiful. We're going to let them cool.
Yum.
So, yeah.
Oh, they smell delicious. It's amazing the smell in here.
Yeah. And again, I had added some chocolate chips. Any kind of chocolate.
I figured top, right?
I couldn't see it. Let's move it this way. Yep, a little bit of sugars on top.
Yep, pull it
and then I had made these a different version. Last week, and Terry tasted them, and she approved.
So good.
So everything's going to be okay now because Terry approved.
They were so good. Yum.
So typically what I do when I take something out of the oven, this is actually newer for me in the last couple of years. I used to just always put it right on a plate, but I decided I would start putting them out.
Oh, cooling them.
Yeah, so that the air gets underneath too.
Oh, right.
So
yep.
That's what I typically do.
Because otherwise they're going to keep on cooking.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. So, okay, thank you so much for joining us. The schmutz is in the oven, and we will show you that at another time. Thank you. Thanks for joining us.
Yum. Can't wait.